everyone, welcome to Fun Food Fashion again. Another episode, another new recipe. Well, guess what? Tomorrow is Saraswati Puja. And as it is Saraswati Puja, I thought about sharing a recipe which is totally connected with this puja. Yes, I'm talking about the inseparable Labra Tarkari. Whenever we heard of Labra Tarkari, we go back to our school days. At least I do, because in my memory, Saraswati Puja means my school days, where we used to stand in a queue waiting for our turn for the feast. In school, we had a feast where two things were there in the menu. One is khichuri and another one is Labra Tarkari. And we used to wait in a queue, then we used to sit in a particular place and our senior used to come with a bucket full of Labra Tarkari and a bucket full of khichuri, and that hot, very nice and hot khichuri and Labra Tarkari. Oh my god, I just can't tell you the memory. Anyways, so I thought about sharing that recipe, Labra Tarkari, with you, because in every household, in every Bengali household, in every school, the Saraswati Puja is celebrated, and every house, every mother make khichuri. So why not try this Labra Tarkari instead of aloodam this year? Well, this Labra Tarkari is not my own recipe. Basically, this is my great-grandmother's recipe, which I have learned from my mother and I'm sharing with you. I hope you will like this recipe. And if you like this recipe, please let me know in the comment section below, so that I know you have loved this recipe. Trust me, you will love this recipe, because I have tried this one and it tastes awesome, just awesome. So without further saying, let's get started. But first thing first, hit that red color subscribe button, okay, so that you don't miss any of my recipes, any of my videos further. Okay, let's go. At first, in a kadhai, we are taking 3 to 4 tablespoons of mustard oil, and you have to let it get nice and hot. Swirl the pan and spread the oil everywhere, and you can see the bubbles. It's already getting nice and hot. To this hot oil, we are going to add 3 whole red chilies, and we will cook it for few seconds till they will change its color and turn quite darker in color, and the entire kitchen will be aromatic with the smell of this red chilies. This will give a nice smell, nice kick into the Labra Tarkari. Next, we are adding panch foron, fennel seeds or mori, and we will fry them for a few minutes as well, so that it gives a nice aroma, nice flavor to the Labra Tarkari. Already the kitchen is smelling so nice. Next, add potato. I have taken one medium sized potato and cut it into 4 pieces here. Fry them. Here we will add the vegetables in sequence. The vegetables that will take more time to cook should be added at first. Then the vegetables that will take less time to cook will be added later.
Next, add drumsticks. I have taken one drumstick and cut them in 2 inches. One by one, add the vegetables. Next, there goes pointed gourd or pothole. One to two pothole. You can use according to your number of members in your family. Just multiply the numbers I'm using here. If you have more guests or more person to feed on, here add flat beans and rigid gourds or jhingi. Add brinjal or begun, snake beans or barbuti. Next, pumpkin or kumro, and mix them all together nicely. Already, because of the panchfuran and fennel, it's smelling so nice. Next, add some salt. We will be adding salt twice. Here we are adding salt for softening the vegetable. It will help the vegetable to lose some water and also get softened up. That's why we are adding salt at this stage. Later on, we will add salt for taste. Next, fry them nicely. Next, add radishes. All the vegetables here, if you can see, all the vegetables has been cut into big chunks so that they hold their shape. Otherwise, they will become very soft easily and they will not hold their shape, and the entire curry will not look good. If it's not look good, if a food does not look good, you will not eat it with so much love. So that is why first you have to take care about the taste, and also you have to take care about the look of the food you are cooking. Next, we have added turmeric here, which gives a very nice yellow golden color. Add banana stem or thor. I have pre-cooked them already in a pressure cooker. I have boiled them. Because it takes a lot of time. Thor or banana stem takes a huge time to get cooked. That is why we are not adding raw. We are adding already pre-boiled or pre-cooked thori here. Next, add grated ginger. At this stage, we are adding ginger. We haven't used it in oil, because otherwise the smell of the ginger will change. If we add the ginger at this stage, it will give a nice smell, nice aroma to the curry. Next, we have added 4 slitted green chilies. This whole red chilies and this green chilies will give it the spiciness or hotness. We are not going to use any dry red chili powders or anything like that. Mix it up. Already the vegetables are getting softened up and changing their texture, you can see. Next, add just a little bit of water, only 1/4 cup of water. We will not be adding much, because this labra thor curry is basically a very dry gravy. There will not be any kind of gravy in there, purely dry curry. That is why just a little bit of water, and the vegetable itself will lose some water, release some water. That is why we are not adding much water. Next, cover it up for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, remove it. See, as I told you, the water has quite increased because all the vegetables has released some water. And also you can see the vegetable has become quite softened up. You can see they have been cooked through. At this stage, we will cook them in high flame. As previously, we were cooking them in low flame, low to medium flame, so that the vegetable can cook through, get cooked through. At this stage, add sugar. This is an optional step. you can skip it. But as it is a vegetarian dish, we are not adding onion or anything like that. So we are adding sugar here. We Bengali like to add sugar in any vegetarian dish. It gives a nice kick to it. It enhances the taste of it. And we will dry up all the water. Few minutes left. Next, add some salt. As I told you, here we are adding the salt for taste. Use salt according to your taste. I'm using half a teaspoon here. Next, mix up. See, all the vegetables are nicely cooked through, but still holding their shape. After 5 to 7 minutes, all the water has been dried up and thickened up. Next step, add the dry roasted cumin and coriander powder. We have dry roasted them in a pan, then we have grind them into coarse powder. Mix it up. I can't tell you how good it's smelling in my kitchen. It's just an awesome vegetarian dish. Trust me, you are going to love this. It's very healthy because it has all the vegetables in there. Now it's done. We have turned off the gas and given standing time for 1 to 2 minutes. Next, take it out in a bowl in which you will serve. Please do try it at home. I hope your family will like it and you will like it. And please let me know in the comment section how you like it. Done. Our Labra tarkari is done.